Hi, my name is Philip Brown and I'm the Bearded Math Man. Hey, what do you think the most powerful component of being a high school teacher is? Maybe you think it's quality instruction or discipline structure. Maybe you think it's routine. I used to think it was those three things, a combination thereof, but not anymore. See, I think your ability to make conversation with students is the most powerful thing that you can do as a teacher. So in this video, I'd like to tell you why I think that and how you can do it. And at the end, the biggest payoff, the biggest thing that has to do with you and your day as a teacher. Now, I didn't always believe that relationships was king. And I also don't believe that if you just have relationships, but you don't have all that other stuff in place, that you're going to be a successful teacher. You have to be balanced. You have to have good instruction and curriculum, and you have to have discipline structure and these routines. But none of it works well if you don't work well with the students. And that is what a relationship is. If you have relationships with them, you can work well with them, and they're going to work well with you, and things will run smooth. I didn't always think that, though. I used to think that discipline and instruction were top dog. And if you had those two things in place, everything went great. And it worked pretty well. But then I saw this episode of Undercover Boss, where there was a 7-Eleven store that was outselling all the other 7-Eleven stores. So they sent the corporate bigwig to, work undercover there. And when he was there, he met this woman that worked there named Dolores. Dolores had been there for 18 years and she knew everybody by name. I'll show you a clip.
Hi, Eugene. Good morning. Good morning, darling.
Well, you know everybody here.
Well, I've been here a long time.
How long have you been doing this?
18 years.
Wow.
Now, there's more to that clip that we're going to see in just a minute, because the relationship between the corporate guy and Dolores, man, something happened really interesting. And it's going to happen for you in your classroom if you create this kind of relationship with your student. So you might be wondering, what does the way that Dolores treats her customers have to do with me and my students? I mean, students have to be in my class, right? Well, yes, of course they do. However, if they want to be there, they're going to be a lot more willing to be participating in the things you set up for them to help them learn. They're going to learn more because they want to be there. It's really important in classes that students don't like, well, mine, math. A lot of students don't like math, but if they like me, then they're going to be much more willing to go along with the things I set up. They're going to be much more willing to do the things I ask. And because they're willing to do those things, they're going to learn. Their life's going to be better. My life's going to be better. It's great. Another reason that you really want to have a relationship with students is demonstrated in this part of the clip.
This store is unbelievably busy, and I was a little apprehensive starting out. But once I got together with Dolores, she made me feel a lot better.
You can start that one.
All right. I don't want to let her down.
You see, if the students like you and they respect you, they're not going to want to let you down. They're going to work for you. They're going to work because they respect you, and your evaluation of them is important. So, typical school day, you have 150 some odd kids and they're shuffling in and out 35 at a time, and man, you've got about an hour and you've got to check homework, you've got to do an instruction, you've got to monitor behavior, you've got disruptions from the office, you've got all those things. How do you develop a relationship with kids in that kind of an environment? Well, it's conversation. You see, not everybody's good at small talk, but kids are easy to engage in small talk because, well, there's a few topics that they are very interested in talking about, and they're safe. They won't make you uncomfortable. Number one, you could ask them about their pets. Hey, you got a dog? What's your dog's name? What kind of dog is it? Do you wish you had a dog? Those kinds of things. Kids will open up. You can also ask them about their families. Like, how many brothers and sisters do you have? Where do you fit in? Are you the oldest, middle, youngest? Man, it just opens up all kinds of conversation. Another thing you can do is, with the entire class, you can share, small little stories about yourself. Now, you need to keep your professional distance, but I'm talking about, like, say in the morning, your toast fell on the floor. Maybe it landed jelly side up, so you know it's going to be a good day. You could share that with them. Or maybe when you were getting ready to go to work, your dog ran out the door, and then you had to go catch your dog, and oh man, it just made everything harried and crazy. Students are going to identify with you. It's going to resonate with them. Another thing you can do to help build a relationship with students is have a pet wall. So have a place in your classroom where students can bring in pictures of their animals, and they can put them on the wall. It's going to make them feel a little bit of ownership to the classroom. It's going to make them feel like they fit, like they belong, like, well, they're welcome. And that's a really big and powerful thing. Another way you can develop relationships with students is with the whole class, is in front of everybody, you give out a sincere compliment. This part's kind of weird, you see. Students gauge their relationship with you based on how you treat other students. Kind of weird. If you give out a sincere compliment to a kid in front of the whole class, man, there's a whole bunch of things that unfold. Number one, that kid that you gave the compliment to, he or she feels better. And they feel good, and they're going to reciprocate. That's going to make you feel good, and oh, it's all puppy dogs and rainbows. But say you give a compliment to Johnny, a sincere compliment, and then Sally sees that you did that. Sally is going to say, oh, well, Mr. Brown treats students nicely. I'm a student, so Mr. Brown must treat me nice as well. But flip side of that, you got a knucklehead in class. Every class has got knuckleheads, right? But if you treat that knucklehead unprofessionally, if you treat that knucklehead unfairly, if you ostracize that student, if you don't like redirect them back to what's in their best interest, you know, doing what we're supposed to do in class would probably be in their best interest. If you ostracize that student, all the other kids are going to say, oh, Mr. Brown's not fair. He's mean to students. I'm a student. He's going to be mean to me. They won't trust you. Man, you got to be really careful. I'm not saying that you let students get away with whatever. I definitely do not. I have some hard and fast rules. There are a few, but I am very strict about them. However, you've got to temper that discipline with kindness. Got to temper that discipline with kindness. Students are going to say, oh, Mr. Brown treats students with kindness. I'm a student. He's going to be kind to me. They're going to be kind to you in return. And all that other stuff is kind of unfold. And here is the best part about having a relationship with students. If you can create conversations with kids, you're going to get to know them. They're going to get to know you. You're going to have good relationships with them. Your day's going to be a lot better. A lot better. You're going to have a much more enjoyable experience teaching. You're not going to be fighting with kids all the time. You're not going to be pulling your hair out. You're not going to be burned out. You are going to have more good days than bad days because you get along with the kids, because you have relationships with them. And that all comes from small talk. Anyway, let me know what you think about all this. Leave me a comment down below. Maybe I'm all washed up. I don't know. Let me know what works, what doesn't. Really want to hear your thoughts. Also, if you think this is a worthy conversation, share it. Also, visit my website, beardedmathman.com. And as always, thank you for watching.